All right, Shalom, Yasha Allah. Back with another GMS on the go. I'm Brother Nakum. I'm with the Raleigh, North Carolina camp. Before I go any further, I'd like to give all honor, all glory, and all praises to the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son, Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rakar Kodash. Next up, double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, from teaching us this truth according to the Bible, and who will well, and the double shalom to all the tzitzakim throughout the four corners of the earth, pushing this truth from righteousness and sincerity to the best of your ability. And I was able to get up to the spirit and power of Yahweh Bahashemah Shah. And you know, I'm just going to go into a lesson on the fear of the Lord. Because that's what you so-called Negroes, Latino Americans, who are the real biblical Hebrew Israelites, that's what you need. You need to fear the Lord. Yahweh Bahashemah Shah. Yahweh being the Heavenly Father, which his name means he is or he exists. And Yahweh Shah being the only begotten Son, which his name means he saves and delivers. That's what you so-called Negroes, Latino Americans need to be fearing. So without further ado, dive right into and grab my first precept. This is Deuteronomy, chapter 10, verse 12. And now, Israel, and that's right, and Israel consists of you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and the Americans, who are the real biblical Hebrew Israelites, according to the scriptures. It reads on, what do Yahweh, thy power, require of thee? That's right. What is Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai? Require. What do they expect from you so-called Negroes, Latino Americans, while you're on the face of the earth, while you're breathing, while you're still living? It's gonna go into it. But to fear Yahweh thy power. That's right. So that's exactly what you so-called Negroes, Latino and Americans are supposed to be doing. You're supposed to be fearing Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah. You see, the one and only living true power. The only power that's been from the beginning, and the only power that's going to be to the end. You see, the one that's making things shake on the face of the earth. You see, the ones who's bringing the storms, the tempests, the tornadoes, the hurricanes, the floods, the forest fires. You see, the ones who are killing and making alive. The ones who are wounded and healing. The ones that's making poor and rich. That's who you so-called Negroes, Latin Americans need to be fearing. And first and foremost, for you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Slovakia, for you so-called Negroes, Latino, and the Americans to be able to fear your power, that fear has already got to be in you. You see, because if that fear is not in you, you're not going to be fearing your Habashi Masha and doing what they command you to do. You see, but if that fear is already in you, then you're going to be doing what your Habashi Masha commands you to do. You see, because I can see for myself and all the sincere brothers around the four corners of the earth. When we heard the apostles and elders of Great Millstone to the men on down preaching these words, guess what? We feared. Why? Because that fear was already in us. You see, so that fear has already got to be in you. So I'm reading that from the top again. This is Deuteronomy chapter 10, verse 12. And now, Israel, what doeth Yahweh thy power require of thee? But to fear Yahweh thy power, to walk in all his ways, and that's right. You see, because if you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans truly fear Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah, then it's going to show. Why? Because it's going to lead up to you walking in their ways. You see, it's going to lead up to you keeping the commandments of the Bible to the best of your ability. You see, because by you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and the Americans keeping Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah's commandments to the best of your ability, that ultimately showed that you fear Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah. You see, that showed the fear that's inside of you. You see, because again, I can speak for myself and all the brothers around the four corners of the earth that's coming to spirit and power of Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah and the truth and sincerity. You see, we started keeping the laws, testimonies, members of the Bible to the best of our ability. Why? Because we fear it first. So if you fear Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah, it's going to show. Why? Because it's going to lead up to you keeping Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah's commandments. And you're going to be doing it to the best of your ability. It reads on. But to fear Yahweh thy power, to walk in all his ways and to love him. And that's right. So if you so-called Negroes, Latin Americans, free Habashi Masha, then it's going to show. Why? Because again, you're going to be keeping Habashi Masha's commandments. You're going to be walking in their ways, doing what they command you to do. And by you walking Habashi Masha's ways and fearing them, it's going to show them that you love them. Because what? You're keeping their commandments. You see, because that's what love is. Love is that you keep Habashi Masha's commandments. And I'm going to grab a precept real quick, just proving what love is. Because here it is, 2019. You got a lot of our people, Israel, so-called Negroes, Latin Americans, who don't know what love is. They thinking love is a funny feeling that they feel in their chest. They thinking love is, you know, those heart-skipping beats. When that's not love according to scriptures. Love according to scriptures is an action. Love is something that you do. So I'm going to grab this precept real quick. This is St. John chapter 14, verse 15. If you love me, keep my commandments. And this is red letter, so you already know who's speaking. That's Lord Yahweh Shai, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus. And he's telling you so-called Negroes, Latin Americans, if you love him, keep his commandments. You see? And that's how you know who the ones of Israel who really love Yahweh Habashi Masha, which is ultimately the elected nation of Israel. Because Lord willing, wisdom of men, we're the only ones keeping Yahweh Habashi Masha's commandments. You see, because 2/3 of Israel by now, they're out here wilding out. Committing all kind of abomination, wicked, filthy acts, doing things that Habashi Masha told us not to do. You see, they're here committing adultery, sleeping with the next man's wife, vice versa, indulging in sodomy, man with man, woman with woman, defiling their temple by smoking weed, cigarettes, black and mild, you know, eating all these abominable foods such as shrimp, pork, crab, lobster, you name it. So 2/3 of the nation of Israel, they don't love Habashi Masha because they ain't keeping their commandments, which ultimately shows that they don't fear. You see, so the only ones who really love Habashi Masha, who are keeping the commandments, is the elected nation of Israel. And that's how we know the elected nation of Israel really fear Habashi Masha. You see, so that's what love is. To keep Habashi Masha's commandments. So I'm going to go back to Deuteronomy to finish that out. This is Deuteronomy chapter 10, verse 12. And now, Israel, what doeth Yahweh thy power will cry of thee? But to fear Yahweh thy power, to walk in all his ways, and to love him. And we just prove what love was according to scriptures. Love is that you keep Yahweh Habashi Masha's commandments. It says, and to serve Yahweh thy power with all thy heart and with all thy soul. And that's right. So you so-called Negroes, Latin Americans, you're supposed to be serving Yahweh Habashi Masha with all your heart. Going back to that Hebrew word, love means your mind, and with all your soul. But the only ones who's going to serve Yahweh Habashi Masha with all their mind and with all their soul is the ones who fear Yahweh Habashi Masha, which is ultimately who? The elected nation of Israel. Because again, 2/3 of Israel, they're not serving Yahweh Habashi Masha with all their mind and with all their soul. How do we know? Because they too be out here wilding out. You can see it through everyday life, which shows a lack of fear. So I'm going to grab my next precept. Proverbs. This is Proverbs chapter 1, verse 7. The fear of Yahweh Habashi Masha is the beginning of knowledge. And that's right. You see, if you so-called Negroes, Latino Americans want the beginning of knowledge according to these scriptures, meaning the understanding of this knowledge, then what do you have to do? You got to fear your power, Yahweh Habashi Masha. You see, you got to keep that commandment. You got to do what they command you to do. Because that's the only way you're going to get the understanding of your Habashi Masha's knowledge according to these scriptures. You see? Because I can speak for myself. And again, in all to sit occupying around the four corners of the earth, that's pushing the truth and righteousness and sincerity to the best of their ability. What? We didn't get the understanding of this knowledge just by not fearing Habashi Masha. No. We got to understand this knowledge by fearing Habashi Masha. By doing what they commanded us to do. You see? So the same way we got the understanding of the knowledge according to the scriptures, is the same way the rest of you so-called Negroes, Latin Americans, will get the understanding of the knowledge according to the scriptures. If you fear, that's the only way. If you don't fear Habashi Masha and do what they command you to do, then you're not going to get the understanding of their knowledge according to these scriptures. You see, because what does your Habashi Masha look like giving you so-called Negroes, Latin Americans, his riches, his secrets, if you're not fearing him? So it all starts with fear. The fear of Yahweh Hashem HaShai equals the knowledge, the understanding of these scriptures. You got to first fear them. This is Proverbs chapter 1, verse 7 from the top again. The fear of Yahweh Hashem HaShai is the beginning of knowledge. But fools despise wisdom and instruction. And that's right. And when you look into that word fool, it means meatball, blockhead, imbecile, jackass, dunce, you see, nickapoo. The list goes on and on. And that fits 2/3 of you so-called Negroes, Latino Americans. Y'all are fools. Why? Because y'all despise, y'all hate the instructions of wisdom according to the Bible. Y'all hate that the two men of the Lord come in the spirit and pop y'all by Shemasha. Come out on the highways and byways week in and week out and throw up all types of videos according to the scriptures on YouTube telling you so-called Negroes, Latin Americans what you can and what you can't do according to the scriptures. You see, you so-called Negroes, Latin Americans, 2/3 of y'all hate the instructions of wisdom. And why is that? A lack of fear. You see, 2/3 of you so-called Negroes, Latin Americans do not fear Yahweh Hashem HaShai, and that's why y'all hate the instructions of wisdom. You see? And that's why y'all don't have the understanding of the knowledge according to scripture, because you don't fear Yahweh Hashem HaShai. So if you so-called Negroes, Latin Americans want the understanding of the knowledge according to scriptures, what do you have to first do? You got to fear your power. And one way or another, you so-called Negroes, Latino Americans, you will fear your power, Yahweh Hashem HaShai. Whether you do it willingly, right now, like the men of the Lord are doing, or whether you do it unwillingly, when Yahweh Hashem HaShai brings all these different plagues and calamities upon the face of the earth, and you get taken by it. But one way or another, you will fear your power, Yahweh Hashem HaShai. So I'm going to grab me another precept real quick. This is Proverbs chapter 10, verse 27. The fear of Yahweh by Hashem HaShai prolongeth days. That's right. So when you so-called Negroes, Latino Americans fear Yahweh by Hashem HaShai, who the world ignorantly calls God and Jesus, who's a so-called black man, when you do what they command you to do, which is wisdom according to the scriptures, that's what gets your days prolonged on the face of the earth. You see, that's what gets you to live a long and healthy life. You see, to where you got gray hairs popping out your head. You see, so if you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and the Americans want your days to be prolonged on the face of the earth, then what do you need to do? You got to fear your power, Yahweh Hashem HaShai. Again, not Allah, not Buddha, not the Hindu god of Shiva, not Santa Maria, not Haile Selassie, not Baphomet. Not none of these false gods who are no gods that 2/3 of you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and the Americans be worshiping. Why? Because they're no god. They're not real. You need to fear the one and only living true power, Yahweh Hashem HaShai. Because Yahweh Hashem HaShai is the way that you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and the Americans are going to get your days prolonged on the face of the earth by fearing them, by keeping the commandments, by doing what they command you to do. It reads on. But the years of the wicked shall be shortened. And that's right. And you see that happening every day. The 2/3 of Israel, so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans, their years on the face of the earth are being shortened. Why? Because they're not fearing Yahweh Hashem HaShai. Look what happened to Eric Gardner. Look what happened to Mike Brown. Look what happened to Trayvon Martin. Look what happened to Sandra Bland. You see, the list goes on and on. Look what happened to Nipsey Hussle. All these people I'm naming, you see, their years were shortened on the face of the earth, all because they didn't fear Yahweh Hashem HaShai, because they were too busy being wicked out here. You see, so if you so-called Negroes, Latino Americans don't want to end up like them, if you don't want your years shortened on the face of the earth, and you want your days to be prolonged to live that long and healthy life, then what do you need to do? You need to fear your power, Yahweh Hashem HaShai. And not just walking around saying, I'm a God-fearing woman, or I'm a God-fearing man. No, actually fearing Yahweh Hashem HaShai, doing what it can make you do, again, which is wisdom. And that's what's going to get your days prolonged on the face of the earth. But again, it all starts with fearing your power, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. That's the only way. So I'm going to grab me another precept real quick. This is like Israel. Bear with me while I'm looking for the next precept. Bear with me 1 second, Akim. Here it is, I found it. This is Psalms chapter 33, verse 18. Behold, the eye of Yahweh by Shemawashai is upon them that fear him. And that's right. And that word behold means to look. So look. The eye of Yahweh by Shemawashai, which are the angels. You see, the angels are upon the ones of you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans who fear Yahweh by Shemawashai. You see, again, which is wisdom, who are doing exactly what Yahweh Shemashah commanded you to do. You see, showing brotherly love, not eating shrimp, pork, crab, or lobster, not marring your beard, making baldness upon your head, keeping the high holy days to the best of your ability. You see, not indulging in sodomy, man with man, woman with woman. You see, the list goes on and on. That's who the angels are upon. They're upon the ones of you so-called Negroes, Latin Americans who fear Yahweh Shemashah, who are doing their will, who are keeping the commandments of the Bible to the best of your ability, which we know is who? The elect of the nation of Israel. Lord will be some men. You see, because right about now, the angels, they're not upon 2/3 of Israel's so-called Negroes, Latin Americans. Why? Because they're wicked. You see, they're not doing Yahweh Shemashah's will. They're too busy doing their own will, doing their own thing. You see? So the angels are not upon the wicked of Israel, 2/3 of Israel, so-called Negroes, Latin Americans. They're only upon the ones who fear Yahweh Shemashah, which, again, ultimately the elect of the nation of Israel. It reads on. I'm going to read it from the top again. This is Psalms chapter 33, verse 18. Behold, the eye of Yahweh Shemashah is upon them that fear him, upon them that hope in his mercy. And that's right. And the only ones that are going to be hoping in Yahweh Shemashah's mercy, hoping that Yahweh Shemashah doesn't destroy them in their everyday life, or even the evil, the bad times that's coming up upon the face of the earth. The only ones that's hoping in Yahweh Shemashah's mercy is the elected nation of Israel. You see? The elected nation of Israel, they're hoping in Yahweh Shemashah's mercy, hoping Yahweh Shemashah doesn't take them out by a famine of food and thirst, which is gearing to come upon the face of the earth. You see, the elected nation of Israel, they're hoping Yahweh Shemashah's mercy that they don't get taken out by these pestilence, these diseases. You see, they're hoping that they don't get taken by these race riots. You see, the RFID chip, which is the mark of the beast, which is gonna come across the whole world. You see, the elected nation of Israel, they're hoping in Yahweh Shemashah's mercy that they don't get taken by those 200 ICBM missiles that are gonna come from the end of heaven, the end of earth, that these other nations are gonna send and destroy this place called America. You see, so the elect of the nation of Israel, they're hoping in Yahweh Shemashah's mercy. Why? Because ultimately, the elect of the nation of Israel, those are the ones who fear Yahweh Shemashah. And that's exactly why they're doing exactly what Yahweh Shemashah commanded them to do, which is wisdom according to the scriptures. That's the fear of the Lord. You see, because you can't hope in Yahweh Shemashah's mercy and hope to get delivered if you're not being obedient and doing what Yahweh Shemashah commanded you to do. There's no point in you hoping in Yahweh Shemashah's mercy. You see, because you're showing a lack of fear. So if you're not being obedient, you see, you're not doing what Yahweh Shemashah commands you to do, then again, there's no point in you hoping in their mercy, because that's showing that you don't fear. So the only ones that's going to hope in Yahweh Shemashah's mercy is the elected nation of Israel, because those who fear Yahweh Shemashah. So like Israel, look for me another precept real quick. Go to the apocrypha. Alright, this is Ecclesiasticus, other known as Sirach in Apocrypha, chapter 1, verse 16. To fear Yahweh by Shemawashah is fullness of wisdom. And that's right. So when you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans fear Yahweh by Shemawashah, then one that only live in true power, then guess what Yahweh by Shemawashah do? They give you the fullness of wisdom, meaning the understanding of these scriptures. You see? And that's why we're able to break down the scriptures the right way. Why? Because we fear Yahabashi Mashiach. In return, Yahabashi Mashiach gave us the understanding of the full wisdom according to these scriptures. So if you so-called Negroes, Latino Americans want the understanding of the fullness of wisdom according to these scriptures, what do you got to do? You got to fear your power. It all starts with fear. That's the only way. It reads on. And fill of men with her fruit. And that's right. And Yahabashi Mashiach is going to fill men, but not just any man, an Israelite man, with her, meaning wisdom, fruit, the knowledge of understanding these scriptures. You see? Yahabashi Mashiach is going to give his elect men wisdom, fruit, the knowledge of these scriptures. Why? Because those men fear Yahabashi Mashiach, the ones who's coming in the spirit and power of Yahabashi Mashiach. That's why you see brothers constantly going into lessons on the fear of the Lord. Fear, fear, fear. You can never go wrong, you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans, with fearing your power. You can never go wrong. I'm going to get one more or two, then I'm going to close out. This is Sirach, chapter 1, verse 21. The fear of Yahweh Bashi Mashiach driveth away sins. And that's right. The fear of Yahweh Bashi Mashiach is what drives away sins. And before I go any further, I'm going to get what sin is according to the scriptures. Because again, here it is, 2019. You got a lot of Israelites who don't even know what sin is. You know, so we got to edify. We got to let them know what sin is according to the scriptures. This is Sirach, bear with me. This is 1 John chapter 3, verse 4. Whosoever committeth sin transgresseth also the law. For sin is the transgression of the law. And that's right. And whosoever is referring to you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans. You see? So the ones of you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans are committing sin, then that means what? You're transgressing the laws that's given to the Bible. That means you're going contrary to the scriptures. You see, because believe it or not, according to Leviticus 26 and 46, Psalms 147 and 19, and many other scriptures, the law was given to you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans. You see, so if you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans are transgressing the laws that's given to the Bible, then that means you're sinning. So that's what sin is, transgressing the laws that's given to the Bible. So we're going to go back to Sirach, chapter 1, verse 21. The fear of Yahabashi Mashiach, which you know is wisdom, driveth away sins. That's right. So wisdom, the fear of the Lord, you know, doing what Yahabashi Mashiach commands you to do, that's what's going to drive away sins from you transgressing the laws that's condemned to the Bible. You see, because you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans, you can't sin and transgress the laws that's condemned to the Bible if you're fearing Yahabashi Mashiach, doing exactly what they command you to do. You see, because either you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans going to be sinning, transgressing laws that's commanded to the Bible, or you're going to be fearing Yahabashi Mashiach, you know, which is wisdom, doing what they command you to do. It reads on, and where it is present, it turneth away wrath. And that's right. So wherever the fear of the Lord is, Yahabashi Mashiach, he's going to take his wrath, his judgment, he's going to turn it away from the ones who fear them, and he's going to turn it to a two-third-ass Israelite, excuse my French, who is not fearing them, and he's going to bring his judgment, you know, they're going to bring that wrath upon them and put them to death, all because they didn't fear, because they were too busy being wicked. Trying to see if I'm going to find one more, and I'm going to close out. Yep, this is Sirach, chapter 2, verse 15. They that fear Yahabashi Mashiach will not disobey his word. You know, and again, that's also talking about the elected nation of Israel. You see, the elected nation of Israel, which consists of so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans, they fear Yahabashi Mashiach. You see, they fear that judgment, that wrath that Yahabashi Mashiach will bring upon them if they ain't doing Yahabashi Mashiach's will. You see, so the elected nation of Israel, those are the ones who fear Yahabashi Mashiach. So because the elected nation of Israel fear Yahweh Shemashah, guess what? They're not going to disobey Yahweh Shemashah's word. They're not going to go contrary to the scriptures, doing things that Yahweh Shemashah told us not to do. Why? Because again, ultimately, we fear that judgment, that wrath that Yahweh Shemashah will bring upon us if we're not doing their will, if we're not keeping the commandments. You see? It reads on. And they that love him will keep his ways. And we already proved what love was according to St. John chapter 14, verse 15. Love is that you keep Yahweh Shemashah's commandments. You see, so if you so-called Negroes, Latin Americans, truly love Yahweh Shemashah like you say you do, then guess what? It's going to show. It's going to lead up to you keeping the commandments, walking in their ways. And by you keeping their commandments, walking their ways, showing that you love them. But not only does they show them that you love them, it also shows them that you fear them. Because you're doing exactly what they tell you to do. You see? It all starts with fear. And that's what you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans need. Each and every last one of you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans need to fear your power, Yahweh Shemashah, before it's too late. Because Yahweh Shemashah is going to bring destruction. He's going to bring wrath, calamities. All hell is about to break loose in this place called America. And Yahweh Shemashah is the one bringing it. So you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans, you need to fear. So without further ado, hope you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans have been edified. Before I go any further, I'd like to give all honor, all glory, and all praises to the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Rakar Kodash. Next up, double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Salaki Israel, I just thought of another precept real quick. Then I'm going to close out. It just hit me all of a sudden. Salakia. This is Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 13. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear the Most High and keep His commandments. For this is the whole duty of man. And that's right. So the whole duty of you Israelite men, while you're on the face of the earth, while you got breath in your body, while you're still living, walking around on the face of the earth, the whole duty of you Israelite men is to what? Fear Yahweh Shemashah. And if you really fear them in truth and sincerity, it's going to show. Why? Because it's going to lead up to you keeping the commandments, walking in their ways. You see? And that's the whole duty of you Israelite men, again, while you're on the face of the earth, to fear your power, Yahweh Shemashah, and to walk in their ways, keeping the commandments. So now, with that, hope you so-called Negroes, Latino, and Americans have been edified. Before I go any further, I'd like to give all honor, all glory, and all praises to the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Rakar Kodash. Next up, double honors to the apostles and elders of the Great Millstone, from teaching us this truth according to the Bible, and who rule well, and a double shalom to all the Sisaikim throughout the four corners of the earth, pushing the truth in righteousness and sincerity to the best of your ability. Shalom.